evening. Welcome to Our City, Our World, a production of Reading's Environmental Advisory Committee. I'm Andrew Molteni. I'll be your host, and Jeff Parsons, my dear friend, is a guest tonight, concerned citizen and business owner.
Hello, everyone.
Here in Berks County. Tonight, our title is The Legislation of Climate Change. And as always, what we're always saying is to get involved and to learn. But what moved me to use this title was the election we just had and the extreme small turnout of people who they're going to use to elect somebody that's going to govern us. And after seeing the way bills are produced and laws made and becomes law by being in government now for over 10 years, it's really time for people to get involved and make their voices known. Because by allowing just such a small handful of people take care and make these rules, you end up with horrible legislation. We have way too many laws at this point for everything. Just to give you an example, one that I'm going to deal with next Tuesday when we have our environmental meeting is legislating the kinds of plants you can have on your property, as in noxious weeds and stuff like that. I think that's going a little bit too far. But would you like to say hello?
You know, and that's actually a whole nother subject that you can spend weeks talking about is, you know, the battles over what you're allowed to grow. You know, I believe it was Florida just this week, passed a law that the individual cities can't outlaw growing, like plants and vegetables.
Oh, right,
and stuff.
Right. Having a vegetable garden in your front lawn, because that used to be able to get you on a jail offense.
Yeah, and that's the thing. Most ordinances, you know, those things were written in the, you know, who knows, the 40s, 50s, 60s and
no,
stuff.
No, they're still writing them, Jeff. My committee's putting them out
they're still
all
writing
the time.
Them too. But like the general like idea of what towns should look like, you know what I mean?
Yes.
Kind of formulated in a certain time period, and people are stuck there. You know, the whole idea of, you know, the monoculture lawn, you know, grass.
Yes.
You know, having one type of plant and killing all others, you know, it's senseless. It's ridiculous. It, you know, it hurts wildlife. It hurts, you know, butterfly populations. It hurts, you know, every time you plow down a field, it's, you know, okay, so nothing was, you know, happening in that field. You put some houses up, but, you know, there wasn't nothing happening in that field.
Absolutely.
There were things living there. And, you know, it's all connected. And
yes,
you know,
most of the planet now has been altered by the footprint of man.
Yes.
And this is why climate change is absolutely true. I hope you understand enough about the science of it to know about this. And the fact that we brought up the legislation is that there is some things to be thankful for. Like a lot of cities now are actually passing legislation on limiting plastic. Mm-hmm. And what you can have. Some places are finally banning styrofoam, which really, mm-hmm. you know,
That should have been done years ago.
Yes, it shouldn't even been allowed, because the way the system we have now, unfortunately, this capitalist system, which I keep saying this, needs to be examined. It's going to have to be really adjusted or changed. That's all there is to it, because it is not conducive to life on this planet. Its mm-hmm. premise is growth. Its premise is destroying to make profit above all else, and that's just not sustainable.
Completely not sustainable.
So that's going to have to be looked at. But in the meantime, we do have this system, and like I said, so they're starting to limit some stuff. I just wanted to bring up a few things that have gone on since the last time we talked with you all. And by the way, you know, this is a call-in show. I'm sure they have the number up there. You can call in if you have any comments, ideas, thoughts. That would be great. Anyway, there's an interesting thing that's in the news this week is that 1 million plastic bottles per minute are being produced now worldwide.
Oh, yeah.
And 91% of them don't even get recycled.
Yes.
They went to the deepest part of the trench to do research just recently, the Marianas Trench. And at 35,000 feet below the ocean, they are finding the organisms even saturated with plastic.
Mm-hmm.
So We are definitely becoming a plastic planet.
Yeah, there was somewhere just recently, I think it was like in Malaysia maybe.
Yes.
There was a river that, you know, just got completely overrun with plastic.
Unbelievable, the videos.
It was like millions of just bottles.
Right,
just,
a river of plastic
just gone down this river.
No, you couldn't even see the water.
And, you know, it's not like it's theirs, you know what I mean? Like where this was being shot. They're, you know, this is a poor place. It's not like they're walking down to Wawa and buying.
Exactly. Well, what happened was when China decided to ban receiving any recyclables, quote unquote, from around the world, because really what we were doing in our, you know, need for profit, we just really were not doing a good job in shipping them garbage. And they said enough is enough. And they banned it. They were the biggest buyer. Malaysia became the fallback, and people just started shipping stuff to Malaysia. And the people there, also being involved in this capitalist system, thought they would try to make profit on it. But you saw what happened. It ended up being pushed into the, just pushed. They don't have the regulations we have. So it ended up being
up in their environment.
Dumped. Exactly. So this is interesting. Just last week, what they did, they started sending the garbage back to where it came from.
Yeah, yes. I believe they sent a big truck full or whatever, barge full back to England or something like that. Yeah, and that's the thing. Like, we see YouTube videos and things of that nature, Facebook, you know, videos of like the Malaysia River and, you know, the beaches, you know, in Haiti or wherever, you know, where all this stuff suddenly washes up. And I think part of that whole white privilege mentality, when the majority of America sees that, I think in the back of their mind, it's their problem and they're ones that caused it. You know what I mean?
Maybe
like
so.
I don't think it kicks into most people that we're to blame.
Exactly. Every time you go to the grocery store.
It's the first world's trash that's ending up in the oceans, ending up on their beaches. When it starts washing up on our beaches and washing down our rivers by the millions, that's when people are going to start noticing around here.
Well,
what I think it's going to take for most people to even notice or care.
Every month now, there's some kind of stories going on about environmental degradation, like the red tide down in Florida that were just so bad and killed up so much wildlife.
Mm-hmm. And the storms we're having are
absolutely outrageous. So the climate is definitely changing. The weather patterns are changing because of it. And back to the legislation. So they're starting to be able to, at a small level, people are starting to take effect. But I wanted to bring in the national picture onto this, too. It's like with Alexandria. She was like a really breath of fresh air, the fact that she got elected. But you can see what's already happening. Now, I wanted to premise this first with about understanding how to use the mind in learning about this stuff. Nothing will be understood until you learn how to use the mind. You truly have to learn how to use the mind to understand the difference between thoughts and intuition, and the fact that thoughts are almost never reality. When you apply logic, you can get 50% of the way there, but anybody like Franklin, Einstein, even the guy that invented the switching devices used in like cell phones, they'll all tell you they came through intuition. Mostly it came in their dreams and they were able to work it out after that. But so you have to be able to learn how to tell the difference, because to understand the nature of this game we're in, most people do not have a clue about what's going on in America, that truly you have no say, that it is shadow government that pulls the final punches and makes the final decisions, even though we elect people and then we have a Senate and a president. But if they do not like what happens, they will find a way to change it, as we could see what happened with Kennedy.
Exactly.
Absolutely. The prime example, when they said, this is it, we are absolutely putting our foot down now and we're going to let the world know.
Yeah, I definitely agree with you there. However, I think that it's changing now in the world because of the changing nature of technology, the changing nature of money, the changing nature of power. And there were those old structures in place that I think had tighter control on everything that was going on.
Maybe so, but they're still quite powerful.
They're still quite powerful.
And dangerous.
But that was old money. That was old power. What you're seeing now is you have new money and new
power. This is true.
You know, you have people like Bill Gates.
Yes.
I mean, how many billions of dollars has that man donated and, you
agreed.
Know, done, you know, whether you
change
agree with...
Change can happen incrementally.
Yeah, exactly. And people, there's people out there doing it. And with the, you know, the final say that the people pulling the strings behind the government, you know, I think the thing is to overwhelm them. Like, because right now they get away with it because it is in the shadows.
But, you know, I think even they have to finally admit that... what they're doing is affecting the whole planet, and they're not going to be able to get high from it.
This is why I personally love Alexandria, is that she's bringing stuff to light to the average person.
Yes.
More than anybody previously. Because
yes.
Whereas most of your politicians don't go to the meetings, don't go to the, you know, the committee meetings and stuff, she's at every single one.
Absolutely, and she does the research herself.
And her... her staff is top-notch because when she gets there, she's prepared. And, you know, she missed her calling as a lawyer because she is great at questioning and guiding questions and getting to points of the matter.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Whether it be when she was talking about the, you know, as marijuana is legislated legal, mm-hmm. you know, the same people that were suffering... you know, because of it being illegal and the damage done to those communities, you know, and the white people profiting off the prisons and the police forces and stuff, you know, now it's those same people that were profiting off of that are the ones now benefiting from the legalization. It's, you know, it's rich white guys, you know, and you know, she is looking at that and saying, hey, why aren't we doing something more to make up for the damage we did to these communities
yes.
through the drug war to begin with by, you know, seeing to it that some of the money gets there, you know, whether it be the opportunity to, you know, be involved in those, you know, community, you know, those, you know, new businesses, the licensing, or if it's, you know, taxes that then go to infrastructure or rebuilding or something, you know, but she was, you know, pointing out those kind of things that most people weren't thinking about. And,
indeed.
You know, when she talks to the, you know, the bank people, you know, she, you know, looks at the predatory lending practices with the, you know, what do they call them? The payday loan or payday loans
yes.
or whatever.
Well, agreed.
You know,
and it's just
loans.
Such a breath of fresh air that she has the courage to step up and bring this stuff
exactly.
to light that a lot of other people that are in the game won't do.
And
will take orders from somebody 50 else.
50 years
she
ago,
is
though,
not,
even if there were people in those committees talking about those things, we now have the technology where, you know, and she's, you know, this new wave of politician that is tech savvy. So,
yes.
you know, she's on Twitter, she's on Facebook, she's on, you know, all these different social media platforms, and the videos of her get out there and, you know, there's people out there editing them and then they get spread and they're spreading like wildfire, you know, wildfire. And, you know, so that's, I think, the difference between now and before now,
yeah,
we have the opportunity for all this stuff to come to light.
Yes,
and you know, and get that shadow stuff out of the shadow.
Right. Well, I wanted
then,
to bring that up just
do,
because
you know?
People have been so brainwashed by. That's another thing I want to bring up. Do you know that truly, what humans do, our reactions to thing, what would you call it? Psychology is probably the number one most studied thing, and has the most black money put into it. Next to
oh, yeah.
the military.
Well, I mean, like,
so they
right
understand
after,
how to control people. So.
Exactly, like it's the like Trump's whole playbook right now is you know, and I've been reading a lot about this because it's been kind of studied because of we're witnessing it happen, is that you know just the repetition of something, even if it's
yes.
a lie.
And Bush tried that too. He was like so blatant, but
yeah.
people
but,
who understand
but
how it works
exactly.
can't catch that. But
you know, and
you're right,
it's the same way with songs on the radio. Like
yes,
there've been studies.
Exactly.
It, you know, the first
sure.
time you hear a song, you might not like it.
That's
but if
play,
they keep ramming
for
down
play.
Your throat,
back in the late '50s and early '60s, was a big thing because they already realized that by then.
Yeah.
All you got to do is get it out there, and it'll become a hit.
Exactly, and. You know, so the politicians are catching on to this and they're, you know, so truth doesn't matter anymore. You know, it matters what you can get people to believe.
Exactly.
And, you know, so.
But that's the last of the old guard playing that game and the programming game.
Yeah.
To control the populace. But the more we learn how to deal with this and the more we get involved, that was the part I put that in there. Get yourself involved. I always say that. investigate, learn how to use the mind, get involved, because things are changing. And, you know, what happens is, I talked this about the lady when I came in here, about how people do get turned off and people get depressed and they don't, why the voting numbers were so low. Mm-hmm. 1,700 people elected the person that's going to run for mayor of Reading. It's pathetic in a town of over 80,000. But so people buy into that and allow their thinking mind to depress them and they don't get involved. But you got to understand that they're just thoughts, and it's never been any different. It's always been the same. All you can be responsible for is how you react to what's placed in your plate. That's exactly all that you are responsible for, and that's all you can do.
And, so, and sometimes that's enough, because sometimes
truly it is.
It takes it that
shows
first
that.
Person
again, right,
to start a movement. And you know, it you know, it's one person leading a march, and then you know,
the light goes
the
on,
light
somebody
goes
else
on
goes,
and somebody
oh,
else
yeah,
follows.
I
them.
Know that.
And
right.
You know, now you have a million people marching to Washington about, you know, whatever. You know, it's that's how movements start. It starts with with you. It starts with the making a decision to stand for something, and then, you know, taking the steps to accomplish a goal.
Yes.
You know, and I'm happy to see that there's more of that in government now. You know, I really feel like, be it, you know, the liberal or the more conservative people, there's a younger wave coming in.
Yes.
And they're pushing out a lot of that old thinking. And, you know, it's refreshing to see.
Right, because they did have the internet. And they, even though they have this programming so well down, there are places out there that they don't get to infiltrate as deeply, and a lot of the younger people go to those places and they don't get the programming that we got. Mm-hmm. When we were kids, we grew up, there was three TV stations and everybody saw and knew the same thing.
Exactly. And really, it was so easy to control then what people thought. I mean, you know, what commercials were on,
yes,
determined what you purchase at the store. What, you know, the you know, Walter Cronkite says on the evening news,
yes,
you know, had a huge
gospel
influence,
yes,
in how you thought.
But, you know, to go back to those guys did have a little bit more
integrity.
Integrity is the best word for it. Yes, it's a very good word. And they did have more than the people around
now. I think the old
now.
News people, I think they made more of an effort to be nonpartisan, to just present facts.
Yes.
And maybe if it was
and
an editorial
the facts,
segment, they would, like, you know, opinion on, mm-hmm, something. But as far as, like, delivering
and
the news.
Many of them lost their jobs over even.
Yeah.
Like, guys,
nowadays,
like
it seems
Edward
that it's Murrow all
was one of the best,
opinion.
And he lost his job from Paley on CBS over telling the truth.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. Nowadays, though, it doesn't seem like there's a lot of just facts being given. It seems like everything is delivered with an angle.
A spin. Absolutely.
A spin. And, you know, and it's, you know,
we're the talking heads and we'll tell you how it is. That's
exactly
why we always say here, people, go out and investigate for yourself. Definitely. The libraries are coming back strong. They have lots of hours. The internet's out there. There's so much to be excited about now, and
it's only, you know, and I know a lot of people kind of get up in arms about 5G and the dangers of, like,
yes,
you know, all the you know, the waves and stuff, but the technological aspect of that is
seems to be very interesting.
We're going to be able to become very connected, like everything very,
yes,
connected, you know, because the amount of data that can travel over those networks, mm-hmm, compared to the current network will allow for, you know, the self-driving cars and, you know, having transponders in everything that's moving. So,
mm-hmm,
you know, everything knows where everything else is to avoid collisions.
Well,
and
the one thing I had to say about that is I hope that the commercial computers are better than the ones they sell us, because I wouldn't want my computer driving a tractor trailer down the highway.
Yeah, well, I mean, obviously there's huge obstacles there, but I mean, there's strides to be made, and
yes,
that goes back again to the, you know, to the, it ties into the recycling and all that is, you know, efficiency, you know, reduce, reuse, recycle. And part of that reducing is mass transportation. It's the efficiency of self-driving vehicles.
This is true.
You know, at regulated speeds and reducing traffic jams and all that.
Well, the,
like,
legislation
that all ties
is
into,
leading to that again. Some places are talking about having milkmen again.
Oh, and real quick, Jay Inslee, the Wisconsin I think it's Wisconsin governor that's running for president. He's started now where she came out with the Green New Deal, and it's just you know, a set of ideas. He's actually started laying that out into a plan on his website for his run. He's actually turning it into actual, like, step-by-step breaking down how we can accomplish these things that they laid out in the Green Deal. He's the first one doing that. So that's kind of exciting. So the next time, we may have a lot more to talk about there.
We got a month to go.
You know, there's the how do you pay for it. There's, you know, what makes sense.
Well, 2 months, every other month.
You know.
But indeed. So we got a minute left. I guess we're going to wrap this segment up on legislation and say get involved. As we always say, get involved. Find out the facts and then talk to your elected people. And if you have to, you keep putting pressure on them.
And there's a lot of, you know, positions that regular people can get. You know,
absolutely.
Like you know, you don't have to necessarily have experience or knowledge. You know,
we still have a seat open on the Environmental Advisory Committee. If anybody would like to come down and work with us, we have an open seat.
And then there's just, you know, committee meetings and you know, anytime the local government has, you know, open hearings for things, like go show up, you know, see what's going on, see what they're talking about.
All right. Thank you, dear audience, and have a good evening. Namaste.